history in New Orleans. So, it says, dear friends, along with mild temperatures and fragrant blossoms, this time of year also seems to bring wanderlust. Sunshine casts its radiant glow over the days of late spring and early summer, illuminating possibilities for travel, and I find myself dreaming of Paris. We invite you to join us as we explore the City of Lights, strolling through magnificent gardens on page 73, ooh yes, tracing the footsteps of the legendary chef on page 57, and pausing at other romantic sites throughout the issue. The serenity I seek often can only be found in a moment's repose. Reflecting on our new Victoria Classics book club section, Gift from the Sea by Anne Morrow Lindbergh, I recognize the value of solitude. There is a quality to being alone that is incredibly precious, she writes. Life rushes back into the void, richer, more vivid, fuller than before. As you escape into the pages of this delightful volume, we hope that the author's easy cadence and insightful observations will prompt your own journey of peaceful contemplation. The longing for tranquility, country home. Her greatest gifts, pieced together like a precious quilt, a mother's tender acts of nurturing come together over a lifetime to wrap her children in love. These stirring tributes, readers share their most poignant memories of this gentle matriarch's comfort, wisdom, and kindness. So this is really lovely because these are all stories that people have added to the magazine to describe what their mothers meant to them or mean to them, and special little stories. Special. gorgeous cakes. I love that design. Isn't that beautiful? Dessert grounds the soiree with sweetness. Rose and lemon layered cake. That's what that is. Swirled coconut bonbons. Delicious. Envelope rich truffles. White chocolate. Oh my god. arrondissement, at the center of this ethereal sanctuary, is a design devotee who found her style early, and embraced it with unwavering bliss. Gorgeous, look at the very soft pinks and whites, and then the pops of green really sets it off. Oh, macaron. Tasty, tasty macaron. Opposite, clockwise from below, the kitchen is a charming assemblage of items collected on market outings, such as embroidered linens and vintage teacups. Adriana is drawn to old silverware with mother of pearl handles. Oh, right there, yeah. She has used a teapot as the vase for a bouquet and perfectly matches the china pattern. That's cool. The bedroom is truly a dream retreat where multiple mirrors reflect the ample sunlight and feathery plumes, pretty perfume bottles, and a lacy dressing gown become part of the decor. Gorgeous. So elegant. A past with presence. A grand three-story structure stands in the prestigious Mazarine quarter of Aix-en-Provence. Its honey-colored stone facade, imbued with a character earned over time. Once a residence, the mansion now serves as a bastion for both art and history. Ah, very interesting. Looks like it has some sort of emblem in the center. It is often said that the best things come in small packages, and these tiny floral compositions prove the adage true in the prettiest possible way. And I would definitely agree, would you not? Oh, it's so beautiful with all the purples and whites and the hint of yellow and the greenery. So gorgeous. So much hope in a little flower, and so many flowers in a little hope. And excuse my tummy rumbling there. Paris forever.